Well, good morning, everyone. Stephen Whiteside here with a look at the North American stock markets for Friday morning. Well, let's call today opposite day. The futures are up in the pre-market about as much as they were down yesterday morning. So we are certainly looking for a higher open Friday morning at 9:30. Well, Thursday turned out to be a wild day. Wednesday was an inside day, a pause day, a day of indecision. Thursday, we broke to the downside, took out the previous 2 days' lows, and we took out the September low before reversing going into the close, closing down just $6.63. Now, when you look at this chart and you look at the width of the channel, you'll notice that it's much wider than it was back here. And one of the things that the channel width will tell you is if we're trending or not. And so when a market is trending, the channel is usually pretty thin and smooth. And as the trend starts to fail, the channel will start to get wider and start to become less smooth. And so that's the situation we're in right now. We are still in a trading range. We took out the bottom of the range yesterday, but did not close there. Now, yesterday turned out to be a bullish reversal day after that big thrust down intraday and then the recovery going back into the close. And so you can see here that we did break down through the 21.25 and the September low, but a very bearish chart pattern has set up where we put in a lower high in September, and now we've put in a lower low in October. And so that is certainly a long-term bearish chart pattern. And we'll just have to wait and see how that works out. Looking at the TSX on Friday, we did trade up to the upper channel line yesterday, so a close above yesterday's high would give us a new buy signal on Friday. A nice big sell-off in U.S. bank stocks yesterday, and the banking index actually generated a sell signal. Canadian banks had a wild day, traded down through the lower channel line before recovering and closing just above the upper channel line. Looking at energy stocks, another down day in the U.S., while Canadian energy stocks actually closed higher after coming down and touching the upper channel line. Looking at gold stocks, so we were up in New York, we were up in Toronto, still on a sell signal though, but we are starting to see some positive activity there. Looking at the chip sector, semiconductors had a reversal day as well and closed lower on the day, making a new low for this move. And transports had a wild day yesterday and actually ended the day higher, while FedEx actually ended the day on a sell signal. So back on a sell signal for FedEx as of Thursday's close. Next up, let's take a look at the three most actively traded stocks from the TSX, the NASDAQ, and the NYSE. Starting off with the TSX, Fortis was the most actively traded stock yesterday. And we have put in a lower low here. We're starting to find support at the $40 level. Buyers are coming in at that level. Yesterday's low was $40.23. And what we're looking at here is the possibility of a reversal, but the stock is making lower highs and lower lows, so not the most attractive stock to go after. We need a close on Friday above $41.58 to give us a new buy signal for Fortis. Looking at Yamana, which is our next stock up, we're down at the bottom of the panic zones. A new pressure zone has formed. We're finding support at the 469 level. Look two lines up, 625 would be our target. There is an open gap there at the 547 level. On Friday, we need to close above 533 to give us a buy signal for Yamana. And B2 Gold, bottom of the panic zones, pressure zone is forming. Now, it's very obvious that traders who are involved in B2 Gold watch the moving averages. Back here, there were buyers at the 50-day. When it started to break down, it had to find support at the 100-day before moving back up. And this time we made it all the way down to the 200-day moving average, so that is certainly a make-or-break level. Yesterday we came back up to the 100-day level and stopped. We've also got a nice triangle here that's forming, and right now we're not projecting a breakout of that triangle, but we certainly could make a breakout of that triangle, so we'll just have to wait and see. Looking up, you can look two lines up to 391, but notice that there's an open gap here that they tried to deal with yesterday, and then there's another big open gap up here. Both of those could potentially act as resistance on the way up. We ended Thursday on a buy signal for B2 Gold, so if you're going to buy it this morning, you have to be willing to sell it on a close below $3.11. looking in the U.S., starting with the New York Stock Exchange, Bank of America, coming off the top of the panic zones, early warning signals formed. We were trying to get to 1641, got as high as 1640 before reversing. And on Friday, we're looking for a close below $15.79 to give us a sell signal there. Next up, we're looking at Valet, and Valet came down to the lower channel line yesterday. We're looking for a close below $5.52 on Friday to give us a sell signal. If you look down, our next mathematical target is 508, but we have an open gap here that the market still has to deal with. That could potentially act as support. And then, of course, we have the September lows that could also act as a target. Next up, we're looking at Chesapeake, and Chesapeake has been finding support around the $6 level. $6.25 is, of course, our mathematical target. $6 is the big round number, and there are certainly buyers coming in down at that level. The low yesterday was $6.04. Looking up on Friday, a close above $6.63 would give us a buy signal there. Moving over to the NASDAQ, the most actively traded stock is Sirius, and not a stock you want to be watching. We put in a lower low yesterday, looking for a close above $4.17 on Friday to give us a buy signal. Apple Computers next up, currently ranked at 10, up at the top of the panic zones. We were trying to get to 1875, couldn't do it, and we may get another chance to do it. And certainly you want to be a seller up at 1875 if you get a chance. You certainly don't have to liquidate your whole position. On the downside, we need to close below 114.01 on Friday to give us a sell signal for Apple. Ericsson showed up on the most active list yesterday after getting pounded. If you look at a monthly chart of Ericsson, you probably are not interested in this stock, but one significant thing you may have noticed if you were following Ericsson is that we did break down on a long-term basis below the 2012 lows, so that is not a good sign given the fact that the stock market is up at close to all-time highs and you're down breaking 2012 lows. That's not a good sign. So there we are. We fell out of the sky heading towards 508 with possible support at the $5 level. And looking up on Friday, there's really no reason to look up. You're going to be nowhere near a buy signal on Friday. Okay, folks, that is all for this morning's presentation. We are looking at a higher open on Friday morning. Dow should open up about 100 points higher. Have a great day, have a great weekend, and we'll talk to you again next on Monday morning.